5, 6, and 7. Let's start together. Who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Wherein we greatly rejoice, when now for a season, if need be, your heaviness and manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith be much more precious than of gold that perishes, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. Paul, are you on the right page?
1 Peter,
it's
in the back there.
Okay. We read verses 5, 6, and 7. Let's go back now. Who is the who referred to in verse 5? My last question.
I'll just read verse 1. The last thing that happened.
Yeah, but who is it?
It's the people in verse 1.
Who are the people? Verse 1.
Scattered.
They're Jews.
What kind of Jews?
They're believing Jews.
Saved, born-again Christians. See, that's the main. Who? Now, what does it mean to be kept? Kept. What does that mean?
You better tell us.
And right there, Tammy.
He's able to keep us from falling.
Keep us from falling?
Oh,
keep us
on, on the bottom there, it has guarded, protected.
That's right, bottom protected. That's right. In other words, once a person is genuinely saved, born again, a genuine Christian, he is kept. Who keeps him in verse 5?
God.
The power of God. And he keeps those that they can't lose their salvation. They may lose their fellowship with the Lord, but they cannot lose their salvation. Yeah, Bill.
If they transgress at that point with that knowledge, it is of their decision that they've turned their back on God.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Wait, what's that? You don't hear us now?
As soon as I called and said I could hear every word, I couldn't hear any word.
You can't hear now?
Right. I can hear you hearing me, but I don't know.
Can't hear now.
Stop talking on the phone and let me hear you talk.
The microphone doesn't. Can't even hear it now.
All right. Here's the you know, speaking. Keep on talking.
All right. Like this. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Continue on.
I'm talking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right.
Can you hear now,
Mom?
What do you have for your ears, Bill?
I hear you 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, that's good. She hears 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay.
That's right.
Your ears okay? Yeah.
All
right. Okay.
All right. Let's continue. Kept by the power of God. Once you're saved, you can never lose that salvation. Who teaches, what churches teach you can lose your salvation? First on the church, yeah, Cass.
I think the Pentecostals
teach. Pentecostals teach that. Who else? Yeah, Tammy.
The Charismatics.
Charismatics, that's right. Methodists, Free Methodists. So they're wrong on that. You can lose your fellowship with the Lord, but you cannot lose your salvation because we're kept by the power of God. What keeps us? What's the thing that keeps us in verse 5?
Power of God.
Yeah, but what else?
Faith.
Through faith. Now, and how long is it? Pastor Paul.
His grace also, I'm not adding anything, but it's also His grace and His mercy.
His grace and His mercy, that's very good. So these are very important things. Kept by the power of God through faith. Now, how long is this keeping in this verse? How long does it last? How long does it last? How long does it last?
Until salvation ready to be revealed.
Yeah, Vaughn.
I don't hear you anymore.
What is that?
I don't hear you speaking through the computer anymore.
You don't hear me through the computer anymore.
Can she hear people in the audience?
Can you hear people in the audience, but on the computer, is that right?
I don't know.
You can't hear through the...
I don't hear anybody in the audience.
Oh, no. Can you hear me?
I hear you now.
Okay, that's fine. That's all we can do. Just keep that way. Just listen to us. All right. Bye-bye. What?
Call
856-854-4452. We'll
get
her
to
remote
hookup.
You want me to have
her call? You can call the landline, and we can hook you up, Mom.
Yeah.
Just wait. We can hook you up with a speakerphone.
I'll show off these things. Okay, Dan says you could. He's going to hook you up. He's going to hook you up to the regular phone line, I guess.
Have her call 854-4452.
Okay, call 854-4452.
For what?
Then you get hooked up. You get hooked up that way.
Okay, 854445.
On the land phone, the land phone that's in the hospital. The hospital phone.
I can't call on my cell phone?
No, not cell phone, on the hospital phone.
No, she can use her cell phone.
Okay.
But call the
if you want to use the cell phone, you can.
The
456. 856-854-4452.
All right, bye.
Bye. Strangest discussion class I've ever had in my life.
Electronics when we get to heaven.
That's true.
Amen.
Are we ready to continue? You're ready to continue? I guess we're ready. All right, so now, how long is a genuine Christian kept? Yeah, Tammy and then Cass and then Anthony.
Mr. Kish said, well, when Mom was calling unto salvation, which is right, which would be when we actually are in heaven.
All right.
Through faith.
What does the salvation mean? Unto salvation. What does that mean? What kind of salvation is that?
Eternal life.
That's until we get to heaven, unto the final culmination of our salvation, which leads us to heaven. So it can't be lost. Now, the salvation, does he think, when is it going to be revealed? The final heavenly status, according to verse 5. Yes.
In the last time.
In other words, it won't be immediate, but in the last time, whenever the finished time is, will be revealed, definitely revealed. All right, and then in verse 6, what is that? No, not yet. So, we'll get Tammy.
Oh, so the last time, is that...
Tell her to call again.
Would that be the end of the...
There, she's calling on this line.
Would the last...
Excuse me, let me just check. Yeah, Rob?
Hi, Pastor. We can hear you, but it's a little, it's distorted.
Distorted.
And, maybe you need to turn the mic down a little.
Put it down. Okay, is that better now?
It's better now.
Better now?
There's a delay.
Is it better now? A little delay, but let's see what it does.
Here's your phone here. There's people's microphones here. That's your microphone.
It's destroyed still.
Well, don't.
Well, we have to keep on talking. Keep on having a discussion.
Hey, turn it down. Just set his phone down and continue. He can stay on the line.
Just let's get a report in a minute or so.
He won't get the turn down until a little bit.
Really, really bad.
Right?
That's right, yes.
Are we continuing now or stopping?
Well, that depends. Are you going to lead us?
All right, we'll continue.
Cool.
All right, so what is the attitude of those referred to in verse 4? What should be the attitude of genuine Christians? No hands? Yes, Tammy.
Rejoicing.
There should be rejoicing. Just a little rejoicing?
Greatly.
Greatly rejoice. Now, what is true at the same time that they're rejoicing? Possibly. Bill, can you hear it in the ears? What might be true while we're rejoicing?
It's fine.
Yes, Tammy.
We're having strong trials.
Could be strong trials. How long might they last?
Just for the time that we're on earth.
All right. Though now for a season. Now, though, in other words, it's not definite, but sometimes it happens as though thou for a season. Then what's that next verse say? Yeah, Cass.
In that verse that we're just discussing, when it talks about heaviness, that could be like losing a child or a son.
Could be a great burden.
It could just last a long time or maybe... Just a short time.
Yes, could be. Yeah. All right, how are we doing? Okay. So that's true. Could be for
yes. Because when that happened to me after dying, my son and my husband, my son, it seemed like I never got out of it for such a long time.
That's too bad.
And I felt guilty.
Uh huh. That's really
because I didn't want to feel like I felt, but I couldn't help it.
Mm-hmm. So is that a sin?
No, it's just it's difficult. But now, what is the though in this verse? What does that refer to? What does that mean, though? What does that mean, though?
What was that question?
Tammy, what does the though mean?
It means that there's a contrast. Here we're supposed to rejoice, but yet we're in heaviness. So those things are opposite of each other. It's like today, this morning, was persecuted, but not destroyed. Mm-hmm. Right. Then that chapter, Paul was talking about a whole bunch of opposite things mm-hmm. that were going on, as well known but not unknown, and just all sorts of things.
So, though, in other words, in other words, though. Yes, go ahead.
I'm just going to say, I knew I'd lose my salvation. I knew that. Yeah. But I knew I wasn't myself.
Right.
Right. Yeah, I tried to, but it just didn't work. I couldn't get out of it.
Ready to reveal, though, wherein rejoice, though. In other words, although it could be now. That's right when you're talking about, right now. Just for a season. What does that mean?
For a while.
Just a while.
It could be a short time. It could be a long time.
For a short time, right there. Then it said, what's the if need be mean? If need be.
It's necessary. That's appointed by God.
That's right. In other words, this, if it's necessary to take place, if need be, what might be your condition when you see all this, the next part of that verse?
You're in heaviness.
In heaviness. And that's what you're talking about, Cass. Very grievous and difficult and hard to take. What would be the cause of the heaviness in verse 6?
The manifold temptation.
Manifold.
Your manifold temptation. Temptations means what?
Testings.
Testings, all right. And so we're kept by God's power through faith, genuine faith in Christ, unto salvation, ready to reveal. But then, though, wherein you greatly rejoice, but for a season there might be heaviness through manifold. What does manifold mean?
Various.
Many.
Many, many, many. Many, many, many testings
many
or temptations.
Many facets. Right. Various, very many faceted, or multifaceted.
Could be. Manifold. A whole lot of them, we know that.
That's
could be multifaceted. Now that... We were in 5, 6, 7. Now, what does the that in verse 7 mean? This is what kinds of that. What does this that mean, do you think?
You're trying your faith.
Oh, all right, but the that itself. Yes, Cass?
I'm not sure, but would it mean the manifold temptations?
Well, no. Yes, Tammy?
For the purpose of.
Okay.
The trial.
Yeah, for the
in
purpose.
Order that the trial of your faith.
That's right. So it says for purpose of rather in order that. See, it's in order that. That's what that means. The purpose. Now the trial. What does trial mean?
Testing.
It means testing again, doesn't it? It's not the person in the court, right? It's a testing. Trial of your faith. What faith would that be?
Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, and a very depth of faith in the Lord. Try your faith. Mm-hmm. Now, what is true of the testing of your faith in verse number 7? What is true? Yes,
he has many temptations.
Okay, Cass. Tammy.
Well. The word precious refers to rare, and mm-hmm. so it's more rare than gold that all perishes. Right. So,
but the your faith is what is it? What is it? How is it defined here in verse 7? Yes,
Anthony. More precious than gold.
All right, more precious than gold, more valuable, scarce, but very precious than gold. Now, do people think that that's the case many times? Faith in the Lord Jesus Christ more precious? No, they'd rather have gold anytime, see. But the faith in the Lord Jesus, genuine faith. Now, what is true of gold in this verse? Pastor Dan.
It perishes.
What does it mean to perish?
It goes away.
It goes away? Right.
It's going to be burnt up when the Lord destroys the earth.
Is this the same perishing? It should not perish, but have everlasting life? And John 3:16.
No, that's referencing.
Yes, Anthony?
You may lose the gold if you don't keep your faith.
All right. So, yes,
well,
it's referring to
people.
All right.
And shall not perish.
That's right.
But this is talking about material things.
Material things.
They're going to be burnt up.
That's right.
At the end.
But the John 3:16, should not perish, probably refer to what place? Where's the perishing place?
Hell. That'll be hell.
Hell, that's right, like a fire hell. So it'd be more precious than gold that perishes. Now, what does it mean, though it be tried with fire? What's that reference mean? Yeah. Okay, Anthony?
I can't hear you.
Okay.
I can't hear
you. Okay. What does it mean? Though it be tried by fire. What kind of testing or trial would that be?
It overcomes your faith if you're scared of fire.
It's possible. What else? What does this mean? Though it be tried by fire. Is that a simple test or a big?
It's a big test.
Big test. A very big strong test. A very important test. Not maybe literally fire, but remember, where is fire also as far as the judgment seat of Christ, 1 Corinthians 3? Where is fire in that particular text?
When it burns up the wood, hay, and stubble.
Yes.
Fire can destroy your faith by burning it up.
Yeah, but in 1 Corinthians 3, what is the fire there?
It destroys the wood, hay, and stubble.
All right.
It's the judgment of
God. It's the judgment of the believers, the Christian believers, saved, genuine Christians. It says, though it be tried with fire, I'd be found to purpose.
What
praise and honor, glory to
Him. Well, that's this verse.
Why is it? Okay.
Here, let me.
1 Corinthians 3, as the judgment of Christ.
Yes, okay, for other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now, if any man build upon this foundation gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, stubble, every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire.
Okay, revealed by fire. Okay,
and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is.
Fire shall test it. Okay, go ahead. And so, if it's hay, wood, and stubble that you're building on as a Christian, what's going to happen to those works?
They'll
fall apart. They'll burn up. See, this is figure of speech here, but in other words, it's going to be passed away. Anybody builds on those kind of works, big works, wood, hay, stubble, great big mountains of wood, but gold, silver, precious stones, tiny, tiny thing, but valuable. So if it be tried or tested by fire, in other words, very strong testing, might be found to what? That's okay, Tammy.
Oh, I was just going to read that last verse.
Okay.
As it says, if any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved, yet so is by fire. That demonstrates that they're not going to lose their salvation.
They'll lose their salvation. That's right. Just the works will be burned after that. If they're not with the Lord, that's true. Found of faith, crave faith, praise and honor and glory. That the faith, what would it mean if the faith were founded on a right out of item of praise? What is praise? Yes.
Everybody says you're a nice guy, you're praising him, he's
right.
Okay.
All right.
But this is going after the appearance of Jesus Christ.
Well, this is at the appearing. That you might be found as a praise at the appearing. That's right. So that God would praise you, and the Lord Jesus would praise you, and honor you, and then be glorified, have glory at the appearing. Now, how many appearings in the future will there be of the Lord Jesus Christ?
Well, it'll be one.
Yes, Cass.
Well, the rapture, but he won't actually be coming down, so
okay.
It would be the next one would be one.
That's right. That's one.
Mm-hmm.
Anna?
Or so you have the blessed hope and the glorious appearing.
Right.
So the blessed hope. I mean, none of the people. Basically, what Mrs. Barber said.
Yes.
Like it's just
blessed hope, the rapture,
and the glorious appearing.
All right. And what's the last? What's another hope?
The second coming.
Glorious appearing.
Glorious appearing.
Now, where does the Lord Jesus come at the rapture? Where's it get, Cass?
It comes in the sky with it.
In the
sky. The angels.
In the air.
That's right. In the air.
Where did it come at the
sky? In the air.
Where did it come at the
Mount of Olives.
Mount of Olives. And when he comes after the tribulation, comes right to the earth. So that's where he's going to be. And trial of your faith, praise and honor, we're at the appearing. All right, that's 4, 5, 6, and 7. Let's read number 8, 9, and 10 together. whom having not seen, he loved, in whom though now you see him not, yet believing, he rejoices with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls, of which salvation the prophet had inquired and searched diligently, who prophesied that grace is promised unto you. All right, let's get there. All right, we'll keep going. So then, we've got in 5, 6, and 7. Now, verse number 8. Who's the whom refer back to? Whom?
Jesus Christ.
The Lord Jesus Christ is the very one he's talking about here. Having not seen, did all the people, is that working then? Oh, not yet, okay. Did all the people that Peter's writing to see the Lord Jesus Christ when he was here?
No.
What does it say right here? Whom?
And having not seen.
They haven't seen him. Have you and I ever seen him personally?
No.
No, we haven't seen him personally. That's right. So, but we still, it says, having not seen what? What is true of those genuine Christians?
We love.
So we love the Lord Jesus Christ, even though they haven't seen him. It's very important to see that. So he's unseen, but love. All right. So that's in verse number 8. Now, what's this though mean? Though.
Now, Danny, you see him.
In spite of this.
In spite of this, all right. Now, you see him not. All right, now. But what is true of the people that haven't seen him? What could be, what could be true of them? In this verse number 8.
You will see him, and rejoice with unspeakable and full glory.
All right. And what do you have to do before you rejoice?
Believe.
Whom do you have believing? Trusting genuinely in the heart. Yes, Paul.
Not only to trust, believing, but also to obey.
All right, believing and obeying. All right. The believing, then what's true? In verse number 8.
Rejoice.
It's not believing, it's believing him even though you don't see him.
All right, but yet
that's
believing.
That's number 8.
Yeah, but verse 8. Yet believing, what can be possible after the...
We can rejoice.
You rejoice. What kind of rejoicing is this? What kind of rejoicing
with
is this?
Unspeakable it? Joy. It's okay. Beyond words.
I what think. Does unspeakable mean?
It's beyond words.
Beyond words, right? Even though there's persecution, even though there's a trial of afflictions, well, they finally got some, after it's two microphones and two other things and everything else.
What works?
I guess we'll have to pay Pastor Dan a little bit extra on this expertise. It costs a lot of money to get a man here to do that.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Each one of us, too, for having to sit through it.
All right.
You get the millionaire, whatever.
Now, those people are listening there. Would you please give us a call and see if you can hear all right to make sure everything's coming through. Call us at 856-854-4747. That's fine. 856, or 856-261-9018. That's my cell phone. Let us know if it's coming through. Maybe if you're still there, probably gave up a long time ago, but maybe still you're there. All right, we almost gave up, but we kept going, singing songs after song after song. It's fine. All right, that's what verse we're on? 7? Number 8. Okay, well, that's love. Yet believing, you rejoice, joy unspeakable, unheard of, and can't even put in words. And what else? What's the next part of joy? Yes.
In 8, it starts out, you love him without seeing him.
That's right.
And then it comes and says, even if you don't see him and you have faith and believe in him, you really rejoice with unspeakable.
All right.
And full of glory. That's you're even happier.
That's the last thing, the full of glory.
That's even glory. Without seeing him.
Without seeing him, that's right. None of us have seen him ever. But those that were genuine Christians, genuine faith in Christ. This can be the case. So 5, 6, and 8, and 9. So what is going to be the reception in verse 9? If all these trials come and you still have faith and rejoice, though we haven't seen it, what's going to be the end of that?
Glory.
And what else in verse 9?
Salvation of your souls.
Yes, what specifically?
Well, here's the first one.
What?
Verse 9, look at verse 9.
Okay.
That's where the question is.
Okay, it's receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls.
There it is. Yeah, Rob. Everything here, all right?
Coming in loud and clear.
Thanks very much, Rob. Appreciate that. Okay. Now, with joy be full, glory, what do you receive? Okay, right. Anna, oh, we forgot to wave you.
We're just waving.
Let's wave again. Wave again. Rob Winograd, Chicago. The first wave. What do you receive in verse 9?
No.
What do you receive?
To receive in the end of your faith.
Faith and salvation.
It says the end of your faith.
All right. The culmination of your faith.
Salvation
of your soul. Salvation of your soul.
Salvation of your soul.
Salvation is wonderful, and even though trials come. So then in verse number 10, it defines salvation. What kind of salvation is he speaking of here? Where did this story at, Tammy?
Well, the prophets talked about it.
All right. What are some of the prophets that might have spoken about this salvation?
Isaiah
certainly did. Isaiah 53 and other places.
Jeremiah.
Probably Jeremiah.
Micah,
that's right.
And
probably also Daniel. Some of the psalmists talked about it. Daniel, I'm sure. So the prophets have inquired and searched diligently. What does that mean? Did God fully reveal the gospel? They had to search diligently. And what would that mean, search diligently? Yes, Tammy?
Well, it was a mystery that was not made known at that point.
Mm-hmm.
It was a sacred secret at that point.
Yes. Hello?
Hello, Pastor Waite.
Yes, can you hear all right?
Thank you. Oh, yes, sir, it's good.
Good, do you want to comment? Go ahead.
Yes, sir. I have two of whom you have not seen, but you believe.
Yes.
This is John 20:29-30. Jesus saith unto them, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they which have not seen yet believed. Let's see. But before that he has said, Thomas answered and said unto them, my Lord and my God. In 28. Yep. He went, yeah, put the new before. I hate to call it late with the verse, but I accidentally called the verse. I just one number makes a lot of difference when you dial.
Okay, thanks very much. Let's wave to Jacob in Texas. Jacob and Dale in Texas. That's good. Thank you. Go ahead. Who was talking? I forget.
I don't know.
Which prophets did rejoice to see?
Oh, yes, they're different prophets. And they searched diligently, and the Lord upbraid
Moses.
Told,
was Moses.
Moses is one, I'm sure. They searched diligently because God did reveal some of the gospel to them, but not everything, like in the New Testament. But that's very important. Search diligently, prophesied. What did they prophesy about in verse 9? Or 10, I'm sorry. What did they prophesy about? Yeah, 10?
Of the grace that should come, which would be the Lord Jesus Christ's salvation. Right. That
salvation, God's grace that should come. So it was very important that we have the prophets. What do the Orthodox Jews not read when they come to Isaiah 53?
The whole chapter.
The whole chapter. That's right. That's what some have told me. Is just leave it out. Why do you think they leave it out?
Because there's a message in there of the Messiah.
The Messiah and the Savior. Yes. Yes. Sorry, Tammy.
They were looking for a king, a political ruler. Mm-hmm. They weren't looking for a suffering servant.
Right. So, but they got the wrong person. So they crucified the Lord of Glory, actually. And then let's read 11, 12, and 13 together. Searching what? Or what manner of time the Spirit of Christ, which was in them, to signify and testify beforehand the sufferings of Christ and the glory that should follow. Unto whom it is revealed that not unto themselves, but unto they who have ministered these things by them that have preached the gospel unto you with the Holy Ghost sent down from heaven, which things the angels desire to look into. Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Like so, 11, 12, and 13, right, starting with 11. Did we finish 11? No, we just started searching. Who's the one that is searching this? Who are searching? The prophets of old, the Old Testament prophets. And what were they searching? What specifically did they want to search? What? Two things. In verse 11?
They wanted to know the time.
Let's go to 10.
they wanted to know the time in which Christ would come.
That's right. They wanted to know what it's all about, searching what. In other words, the whole situation, what it means, and the time, you see. What manner of time. Now, who was it that was speaking to them in the Old Testament according to this verse? Pastor Dan.
The Spirit of Christ.
Spirit of Christ. So that's interesting. The Lord Jesus Christ was helping and ministering to the Old Testament prophets in his pre-incarnate state. What does it say? Where was the Spirit of Christ in regard to these prophets of Old Testament? Where was he? According to verse 11.
Which was in them.
So the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ was in the Old Testament prophets. So that's an Old Testament statement of faith, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Which was in them. Yes. And then what did the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ, say to them in verse 11? Mm-hmm.
I told them how Christ would suffer and then the glory after his resurrection.
All right. The Spirit is signify. What does signify mean?
Show.
To show or point out. That's right. Or show or point out. What is when it testified beforehand, way in the Old Testament. Two things. What is it? First is what?
Beforehand.
Yeah. What is suffering? Two
things. Sufferings of Christ.
Sufferings of Christ.
And the glory that's going to follow.
The glory that follows. Those two things, the Spirit of Christ in the Old Testament prophets signify and show to them. And then in verse 12, unto whom? Who's that refer back to? Whom? And Pastor Dan.
The prophets.
Old Testament prophets. Yeah. It was revealed, what was revealed unto the Old Testament prophets in verse 12? What was revealed? Yeah,
that there was a Savior coming?
Verse 12. It was revealed.
Revealed.
That what?
Unto us.
But first, not unto whom?
Not unto them.
Not themselves, not to these prophets, but unto us. So, did they do what?
Minister.
They ministered these things.
Nothing.
The things which are now reported unto you. All right, so they're reported.
That's
so long.
Right.
Yes, go ahead.
So the prophets were ministering to us in the future about Christ's coming. So that not to themselves, but to us. So that we could look back and see how the Lord Jesus Christ fulfilled the prophecies of the Old Testament.
That's right. So we could see that the Old Testament prophets did predict many things that we now know in the New Testament, now reported unto you. Reported to these Old Testament prophets, what they report unto you. Who's the you referred to here? Reported unto you.
The believers.
Which believers?
The believers that he was talking to.
Okay, yes, 10.
The Jewish saints that were standing in Cappadocia, yeah, the people, yeah. Asia,
all the people he's talking to, he's right to cast, the ones that are he's writing to, Christian believers. I report unto you. Who reported them? Who reported them unto these readers?
The ministers.
What does it say? What are the words that they use? Right, by them that have preached the gospel. That's where it's reported, them that preached the gospel to these people. What is the gospel? How would you define that?
The word of God.
That's part of it. What is the gospel? Yes, Cass?
The gospel is the Jesus Christ dying on the cross for our sins, being resurrected from the dead, saving us. He took our sins. Upon himself.
Pastor Dan?
I don't know if I got the whole thing.
We got quite a bit of it.
The word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing and dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and is discerner of joints, discerner of the thoughts and marrow intents of the heart. So the word of God is the Spirit of God is what it does the convicting work.
Right.
Working together, and it convicts men of their sin. And demonstrates to them that they're a sinner and their own works cannot grant them salvation. Doing good things, being nice, and all these different things. Salvation is not by works, but it's by faith. And it starts with the Spirit of God and the Word of God working in the hearts of man.
And according to Romans 1:16, what does the gospel do? What is the gospel there?
That's
right. Let's say Romans 1:16 again.
For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God and the salvation for everyone that believeth, the Jew first and also the Greek.
So those that don't believe, is it the power of God unto salvation?
No.
No, it will not give them anything. But unto us who are saved, in other words, the power of God unto salvation to those that believe, whether Jews or Gentiles.
Pastor?
Yes, right.
Well, are you saying that that's not the gospel?
What is that?
Jesus Christ died on the cross?
Oh, yes. But I mean, say that's Paul's take on it, the gospel. He didn't define specifically everything, but it's the power of God and the salvation.
We can't be saved unless he did it for us, because we can't do it ourselves.
But, yes, Anna.
Okay, I just wanted to make that clear.
Yeah.
I think his point is that before we can accept Christ as our Savior, we need to realize why we need him as our Savior.
Yeah.
You still have to have him to do it.
That's right. I usually take that question in.
Yeah, continue on what Mrs. Weber was saying in 1 Corinthians 15. One comment was for a previous comment, but this is for about the gospel. Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel. This is 1 Corinthians 15, 1 and 4.
Okay.
Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel, which I preached unto you, which you also have received, wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved, to keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. We delivered unto you, first of all, which ye also received, how that Christ died for our sins, according to the Scriptures, and was buried, and that he rose again the third day, according to the Scriptures. So there's the elements of the gospel there. 1 Corinthians 15, verses 1 to 4.
Okay. 1 to 4. I usually like to say when I talk about the good news, it's good news, but it also has a little bad news. The bad news is we're all lost and bound for hell. That's the bad news. If we don't do anything, just exist. The good news is the Lord Jesus Christ died for our sins. The sins of the people who want to believe the good news, that's good news. And that by faith in him, we can have everlasting eternal life. We must accept that Savior before we have that eternal life. So the good news of the gospel. Now, evangelism, lots of people call, is he a gospel preacher or not? What are some of the so-called gospels that people are preaching today in the churches that are wrong gospel? Yes, Tammy.
The gospel of good works.
Good works. Pastor Dan.
The gospel of prosperity.
Prosperity. Yes.
Well, gospel, you can belong to a church, and if you stay there all your life, you'll go to heaven after you go to other places first.
Yes.
But that's not really the gospel.
No. And what is the gospel of the Roman Catholic Church?
That's what they believe.
Yes, Pastor
Dan. It's the gospel of the authority of the Bishop of Rome,
mm-hmm.
which supersedes the authority of Scripture.
Yes. They teach that, don't they? Yeah, Tammy?
The New Age gospel.
Yes. And what is that? Give that expression.
Well, I guess man can become God.
That's true. And that's what they say. That's what they preach. All these false gospels. Did Paul have any reference to false gospels in his Bible, his books?
Yes.
Yes,
Galatians.
He did. Yeah, Galatians. These false gospels, false teachers, and so on. And
follow
so,
the law, and you'll be
follow saved. The law, and be saved. That's right. Justification by the law of Moses, which is absolutely false. So, there again in verse number, what are we in, 12? The gospel.
Right.
Unto you, with the Holy Ghost. Where did the Holy Spirit come from in verse 12? Where did the Holy Spirit come from? Heaven?
Sent down from heaven.
When was the Holy Spirit sent from heaven as an event that we know about? Yeah, Pastor Dan.
When the fullness of time was come.
All right. And when was the time that was come that the Holy Spirit did come upon this earth? Was it?
Pentecost.
Yeah, the day of Pentecost, that's right. And so there was a special... in the Old Testament, what was true of the Holy Spirit and some of the believing Jews? Okay.
He just sort of came and empowered mm-hmm. them for certain tasks, and then mm-hmm. he left.
Coming and going, that's right, didn't stay. What is true of the genuine Christians today in regard to the Holy Spirit? Just that, Tammy?
He baptizes us and seals us and empowers us for service,
mm-hmm.
regenerates us,
Does the Holy Spirit come and go and leave the Christian today?
No.
He's permanently with us. Even though we have, if we follow the flesh, the crops of the flesh. The Holy Spirit is within the genuine Christian, but what does the Holy Spirit think of us when we follow the flesh? What do you think God thinks of us? He's grieved. Grieving the Holy Spirit is very serious. So now it's permanently involved in dwells genuine believers. Are down from you with the Holy Ghost, sent down from heaven. Now what is true of the angels here? What do the angels have to do? Yes, Pat?
They desire to look into it because they don't know of all the details of salvation. Mm-hmm. It's a mystery for them.
The angels desire to look at it. I'm going to stop right here. I know Pastor Dan maybe work out the thing to get some sort of continuity.
You got to get going.
Oh, yeah, I know.
To the hospital.
That's true. So, sometime we can work this out, I guess, either from the tape or whatever.
I'll have to work on it, yeah.
Okay. All right. Let's close then with a word of prayer. Our Father, we thank you that it was difficult with all the different things we've had to do with the sound. Thank you for this book of First Peter and these first chapters, verses in the chapter we talked about. We thank you, Lord, that even though trials and testings may come, those of us who are genuinely saved can rejoice in our Savior, receiving the end of our faith, salvation of our souls in the future, one day, when we get our new bodies, we'll be completely separate and saved and in heaven with thy Son and with thee. We thank you for thy grace. Bring us back safely on the Lord's Day, or the prayer meeting night on Thursday. We may continue to study the book of Romans. Guide us and with us and help us to live for the Lord Jesus Christ. But if we're not saved, help those who are not saved, those who are listening either on our service here or in the internet, they may sincerely trust the Lord Jesus, realizing that their sinners and lost, that he died for their sins, that they may have eternal life. Guide us and direct us in Jesus' precious name, we ask.
Amen.
Amen. Well, thank you for coming.